Hello everyone, thank you very much for attending this seventh Katia Jewel talk. It's always a pleasure to be with you, trying to explain to you some of the jewels, sometimes best kept secret jewels of Katia. But this one is not so, let's say, kept secret because it's something new, okay? We added recently, I will explain to you how and when, a new capability in Katia to automatically generate 3D annotation and tolerances from the functional description of a part within an assembly and all the mechanical interfaces which are putting in position and maintaining the part in position within the assembly. Let's have a look. Let's start first. Of course, here we are talking about 3D Master. 3D Master is mainly the vocabulary used by Dassault System to explain that if you are just using 3D modeling to design the part, but then still relying on drawings to produce the information for the manufacturing, inspection, maintenance, after sales, you are dead, guys. Because there are a lot of inconsistency between the drawing itself and the 3D model. So, and because of this inconsistency, you have a lot of errors at the manufacturing level. And as you know, at the manufacturing level, those errors are highly, those errors are really expensive to the company. The main idea of 3D Master, sometimes it's called model-based definition, sometimes it's called some other wording, but is the fact that you are, by the way, designing model in 3D, but the good news is that you can tolerance, dimension, add all manufacturing information or inspection information or after sales information in the 3D document itself. And 3D Master is the definition, and the drawings which are generated from the 3D Master definition are just, let's say, capture like screenshot that you can, of course, distribute and share to the downstream process suppliers, which will be in charge, for example, to manufacturing for manufacturing a given part. Okay, so that's the main idea of 3D Master. And we have a lot of application in Katia since many, many years. In Katia V5, in 3D Experience Katia, we have a lot of application to do conceptual and preliminary design, to do the 3D Master product definition, to present and generate the drawings or let's say the 2D information from the 3D Master information, and to review, to view, to display some free players, some online player, some on-premise player. So we have a lot of stuff, but today I will just focus on the kernel, the authoring part, how you are defining 3D annotation, 3D dimension in the 3D model, and introduce, because this is the main goal of this session, something which is very, very new, this new generative torrencing. But let's still explain to you what Katia is able to do right now, and for, by the way, many years. Let's look at the video. It's a very simple part, and you have to do the 3D torrencing and annotation schema of this particular part. And the most important thing is that if you want this schema, this tolerances in 3D to be perfectly well understood by the downstream processes application or your suppliers, you need, it's not an option, you need to stick to standards, ISO standard, NC standard, ASME standards, GIS standards. Because if you don't do that, people will interpret this information in a different way, and you will get the same trouble, the same problems that you have today coming from the inconsistency between the 3D model and the 2D drawings. So in Katia, since many, many years now, in V5 and 3D Experience, we have this semantic advisor which guides the user to really stick to the standards and provide a fully compliant 3D torrencing and 3D dimension schema to be used by everyone in the company and, more important, outside of the company. At the very end, you can get quickly to such the dimensioning of the 3D part. Very important as well, since many years, we have in CUTIA something that which is checking what you did. For example, I dimension my part, I put here a symmetry tolerance. Someone is making a modification on the part. He did not check exactly how the sketch was done. And as you can see, he broke the symmetry in the sketch. Not a problem. CUTIA will highlight the issue. Hey guys, you made a mistake. This symmetry tolerance is no longer fulfilled. Please modify that. So either it's normal, it's a normal design change and you modify the tolerance, or you change the design to stick to this symmetry constraint. So I go back to my sketch. You can see there is an highlight in the graphic window in red, but also in the spectre in yellow with a yellow sign. I just go back to the sketcher and I will very easily change the sketcher, get back to the symmetry property, and everything is fine. You can go further in CUTIA. You can go further because you can automate and reuse existing tolerancing templates. This is quite nice. It's also something which is not new in both V5 and 3D experience. In this particular case, I define this T-slot. I prepare all my dimension tolerance on the T-slot. I do the same for this pinhole. And then I will reuse both the geometrical template to create the slot and the pinhole template to create the holes, but I will be able to import the annotation set to the various slots, the green one, and all the link between the geometry are automatically rerouted. Same for the pinhole template. And very quickly, you can generate or create a template, tolerancing schema. And you can see this particular dimension is really linked to the real faces it is referring to. And very easily, you can almost speed up the generation of those tolerancing. Now, we just develop something to go further and to go faster to create those 3D tolerancing and annotation. Before that, remember that once you have defined a tolerance on a CUTIA 3D model, or it is automatically, not really automatically, on demand, you can declare this tolerance or set of tolerance as consumable. What does it mean? We will automatically generate a requirement that can be managed by our requirement management solution in the 3D experience. But these requirements can be then consumed by either the Simulia apps to take into account those parameters to create and validate by FEA, the behavior of the part in service, or consumed by our Delmia manufacturing suite of roles that will use this dimension to, guide the manufacturing devices, such as machining or inspection. What is new is that now it's really a paradigm shift, what I call the quantum leap, okay? Now, from just the mechanical junction and the functional surfaces, we will identify interdependency between those mechanical junction and functional surfaces, looking at the failure that will be caused by defect of the relative positioning. And this analysis is automatically done by CUTIA, and the consequence is that we generate automatically a 3D functional tolerancing schema conform to either ISO or NC-ASME standards. How does it work? In CUTIA, maybe you are not aware of that, but in CUTIA, only 3D experience CUTIA, in CUTIA V5, the first things to do is you can create mechanical interfaces. It's very simple. A mechanical interface is just a structured set of surfaces of a part which are designed to mate one part to another. And you have primary, secondary, tertiary surfaces, which are most constraining to less constraining. The yellow or the maintained surfaces are just there once the part is put in position to maintain the part in position. Okay, let's move forward. So we will do that on the same example that I showed you. Oops, I was a little bit too fast. sorry for that. Up. This is the assembly we are working on, okay? You see there is a lower support, an upper support, a damper, and two pins, two tightening pins, okay? Let's start with the lower support. We have to define the mechanical interfaces. Remember the definition, it's just a set of surfaces which are designed to mat one prod part within an assembly to another one. So we will here, for example, first start to define the mechanical interface between this lower support and the ground, okay? So it's just a contact, it's a primary surface. And then we have two, let's say, tightening holes and with a clearance. And this will be my first mechanical interfaces for connecting the lower support to the ground. Now we are looking at the lower support to the higher upper support mechanical interfaces. So there is, of course, a contact, but there is also two tightening pins. Here we go, and there is a thread. So this is a mechanical interface between the lower support and the upper support. Now we are also a mechanical interface between the lower support and the damper itself, okay? Oops. Now we are working to define these mechanical interfaces on the second part of the assembly, which is the upper support. In a very, very simple way, very, very similar to what I did previously on the lower support, I define those mechanical interfaces. It's something which is easily done and completely understood by the mechanical designer, because in fact, in reality, he's designing his assembly this way, okay? Here, for example, I have this tightening pin and this the thread to connect the lower support and the higher support together. Finally, it's more easily understood. You put the damper, you define the mechanical interfaces of the damper. Now we have also something which is, once you have defined those interfaces, those mechanical interfaces, you just have to put in position those parts in the assembly. This is quite simple. I have my two pins. We create what so-called engineering connection, and we locate the or position the pin at the right altitude, I would say. Same for the second pin. And very easily, we will put in position all the parts together within the assembly. Here we go. That's the first step. Now, very nice capability of CATIA, which is new, which is an existing command of 3 Experience CATIA. We can validate and check that what we developed is good. Okay, let's go first with the lower support. The lower support has multiple mechanical interfaces. You can display them. The lower, the upper, the damper. And now we will be able to check the validity of what we are doing. Okay. Let's go, for example, back. This is just a display of what is done for all the parts within the assembly. And it was just a display. Now we are just verifying, checking. And you see here that, for example, for the lower support, there is a mechanical interface which is not really connected. In fact, yes, we did not define how the lower support was connected to the ground, okay? So it's really why it's not really connected positioned, but we can say we can accept that, or we can modify this connection. So if I look at the action, I will say, okay, I validate the current status. Now, if I look at the interface between the lower support and the upper support, you can see that, for example, this mechanical interface is not really fully in contact with the upper support, okay? And it's why CATIA is displaying a 62% contact area, okay? So very easily, you can really focus those mechanical interfaces to the real portion of those surfaces in contact each other. So this is done here with this checking tool. And at the end, we can even, let's say, display or color or do a cross-hatching to show to the user what is really in contact between the various parts of the assembly. In this particular case, for the lower support, you can see what is in contact with the upper support and what is in contact with the damper. We can even change the display, the cross-hatching schema to make it even more understandable. So we went to two steps. Design the mechanical interfaces, CATIA classic command, check, CATIA classic command, and now we create junction. What is a junction? A junction is, in this case, not a structured set of surfaces, but an unstructured set of mechanical interfaces, again, to put in position a part within an assembly and to maintain in position a component in an assembly, okay? It's very simple. So we will do that for, we will define the mechanical junctions. Here, for example, for the lower support, we will tell how those various mechanical interfaces are, let's say, put together. So here I have a positioning of the lower support on the ground, then the positioning of the lower support versus the upper support. So really junctions, I put together those various mechanical interfaces. Again, it's quite simple. Looks complex. It's not at all complex. It's very, very straightforward. It's very, very logical, okay? So I will just speed up a little bit because it's really the same stuff on every single part. How those mechanical interfaces are joined together or coupled, if you prefer, together. Here, for example, the damper is in contact on the lower support on the right side and on the upper support on the left side. Okay? And those mechanical junctions are defined. I'm fine with that. I can go to the next step. The next step is that if I have other functional surfaces, which are not really here to put together, to put in position together a part within a given assembly, I can define them as well. And now from the definition of those mechanical interfaces, those mechanical junctions, I can generate or ask CATIA to generate automatically the tolerance. It's very simple. We do not today, but it will come in the future, generate tolerances between parts in an assembly. We are just generating the tolerancing and dimensioning schema on every single part of the assembly, not on the assembly itself. So not a very important, it's not magic. Okay, here there is no magic. We cannot automatically define the value of the tolerance. So what the system asks, what CATIA asks, is in the settings, you can define the quality of the assembly connection. It can be, you will see, intermediate quality, high quality, rough quality, okay? And this will drive the value of the tolerance that we are putting by default. And then it's up to the user, depending on the quality and accuracy of the contact, to define the right tolerance he would like to have. So once this is defined, I just generate automatically all my dimension, all my tolerancing, again, sticking to the standards. It's not that easy to define all those parameters, all those symbols, okay, to stick to standard. It's a real job. It's a full-time job. You need a lot of expertise here by default, but in this case, you don't need that expertise. You just need the classical mechanical designer skills. You know what is a contact. You know how the parts are put together. It just, let's say, gives the system the ability to compute for him the right annotation with the right content of all those dimension and annotation. And finally, you can do that automatically for all the parts within the assembly. Watch out, this will be a particular new licensing in 3D Experience CATIA, which will be in fact pay-per-use. As many dimension CATIA is computing for you, you will need some, let's say, some credits. Okay, I don't want to enter into the detail of this licensing issue. But look at the benefit. You do very, very quickly something which might take some time and, of course, require a lot of skills on the user side to being designed with the right information and the precise information and, again, compliant to the standards. So if I look at my generative functional tolerancing added value, it's a new role. If you have already functional torrencing in 3D Expanse CUTIA, you can just ask to get this new role. Of course, obviously, we increase the productivity because the torrencing is automatically generated. We ensure very, very high quality and fidelity to the standards, ANSI, ASME, ISO, because that's just the way it has been developed. It's really we help the standardization. Every engineer within the company will produce the same type of torrencing schema and dimensioning schema. And very important, we have also traceability because, as you see, the mechanical interfaces and the mechanical junction are creating the torrents. So we can go down. So from the torrents, there is a link to go back to the mechanical junction and the mechanical interfaces. So it's a full traceability of the system. And finally, just a summary. And this is something I used for my friend Jeff. I don't know if Jeff is located in North of America, is attending this presentation, but he will probably recognize a model that he designed maybe 1 year ago. And here it's not an automotive product, neither an aerospace and defense, it's just a mold for a rubber tire. It's very complex stuff, by the way. But here, now, if I want to create the torrencing on this particular piece of the mold, I have to define, as I showed you earlier, the mechanical interfaces. Here you have contact. Then on the rib, you just have some clearance mechanical interfaces. Then for this one, it will be tightening. For the four guys on the, it will be a thread. As you can see, by just clicking on one, I can define only one, and automatically CUTIA recognizes that there are similar holes, and it will automatically aggregate them. I define once the mechanical interfaces are described, I can go now to define my mechanical junction, how the mechanical interfaces are fitting together. And from this description, I will be able to generate my tolerances automatically, thanks to generative tolerancing capability of 3D Expanse CUTIA. Here we go. So thank you very much for your attention. I hope you liked it. I think it's very great. We are just at the beginning, okay? We will go further, we will improve the stuff, but it's a very, very strong capability of 3D Expanse CUTIA. And I am sure you will be interested to get much more information. And if you want to do that, you just have to connect to go.3ds.com/CUTIA and you will have much more information. Again, it was a pleasure to present to you that just before Christmas. It's my Christmas gift. So many thanks for your attention. Do you have any question? If you don't have question, let's go this way. I wish you a very nice Christmas time and enjoy 3D Expanse CUTIA in the future. Bye bye, guys. But maybe they have question. You have question. Let's have a look. Yes, we can share the presentation. The answer is yes, we can share the presentation. Yes, it's 3D Expanse CUTIA. Some people are calling it CUTIA V6. It's not CUTIA V6. CUTIA V6 was the name of the version after CUTIA V5 up to 2013X. After 2013X, it was called 3D Expanse CUTIA. If you don't have, and Jeff, hello Jeff. if you don't have any other question, I stop the presentation here and enjoy Christmas time. Bye bye, guys.